A few years ago, a beautiful woman fell in love. She was 40 when she got married. And you know, as is the dream of every married couple, she wanted and waited for a child. Unfortunately, heartbroken. This phase can be a devastating phase in a woman's life, especially as it not only affects her health, but also the mental and the emotional health of the couple together. By the way, the woman that I'm talking about is former Miss World Diana Hayden. In 2016, Diana delivered this beautiful baby girl, Arya. Diana's baby girl, Arya, was born from an egg which was preserved for 8 years when Diana was 34. So how did this happen? I think before getting into all the technicalities of vitrification and what it is and everything, let me explain to you the biological clock of a woman. When the child is actually in the womb of the mother, you know how many eggs are there? 5 to 6 million eggs. And when she gets born, those eggs become just 1 million. So many of them die. At puberty, it's about 2 to 5 lakh eggs. And mind you, at 37, they become just 25,000 eggs. And when she turns 50, it's only 1,000 eggs. See, this is important to grasp because as the woman ages, it becomes difficult for her to conceive. You know, nearly 70% of the people at the age of 40 find it difficult to conceive. Another problem associated with age is also Down syndrome. And this can be prevented today. When the girl is 30 years old, she has a chance of having a Down's baby that's 1 in 1,000. But when she turns 40, the chance increases to 1 in 100. Then there are other diseases which affect the ovarian reserve, which help, you know, which prevents. And these problems which I'm talking about can be helped by technology. You know, like endometriosis. We have endometriosis as a disease which attacks the ovaries, the abdominal cavity, everywhere. And what it does is reduce the fertility rates, makes it difficult for the patient to get pregnant. Then the other conditions are benign, you know, cyst adenomas, any kind of tumors in the ovary, multiple surgeries sometimes, you know, because of cyst, doctors have to do multiple surgeries on the ovary. Those are the conditions which can potentially harm the ovary. Another condition that we must remember, all of us, is cancer. Today in India, there is no life after cancer. When cancer is diagnosed, people are shocked, they're depressed, they don't think they will be a cancer survivor. But I want to put this message out today that today cancers are curable. There are a lot of cancers which people fight and live to tell the tale. I have so many patients who come to me and say that we want a baby. They have just had chemotherapy, radiotherapy. Now the problem with this is that the chemotherapy and the radiotherapy damages the ovaries. So in these cases, what do you do? All these cases, you must remember, has a solution. But before I go to that, can I have an audience, some volunteer who's 20 to 21 years old and who'd like to just volunteer?
Hi, ma'am.
What's your name and could you introduce yourself?
So my name is Samiksha, I'm 21 and I'm currently studying biotechnology.
Okay, 21, wow, what an age. I'd love to be that. What is your plan, future plans?
I wish to do my post-graduation and then maybe an MBA.
I think today's generation all wants to do post-graduation and MBA is a must. Absolutely. So then when do you plan to get married, have babies? What is the thought process in your mind?
Get married by the age of 28 maybe and babies after 32.
Wow. Okay. So I think today's women all have a kind of a similar plan in their mind. You know, study, they want to become independent. It's so very important. So let's put Samiksha and take her into two scenarios. One scenario is Samiksha gets married. I mean, first she gets her degree. She gets a fabulous job. The people are waiting for her. You know, young, with innovative ideas. They want her. The companies want her. And then she finds the man of her dreams. She gets married. And after a couple of years, they decide to start a family. So Samiksha takes a sabbatical from her work. She has a baby. A couple of years definitely are lost because child rearing. Then she decides that she wants to have another baby. So in this manner, about 5 to 10 years of her life are spent in motherhood. Let's take the other scenario. Samiksha is working and she has decided, she meets a guy of her choice and they both decide that their careers are important. She's ambitious. She wants to become the youngest CEO in that company. So she works, she gets her promotions, you know, spends the whole midnight oil working. And she becomes the youngest CEO at 40. And then she says, okay, I've achieved what I want to do. Now I have the time. I have the money. Let me have a baby. Because she realizes that is the void in her life. And what happens to her? Frustration, because as I said before, 70% of the people who are the girls who are at the age of 40 face infertility. And she's terrified of having a Down's baby. So what is the solution to all this? What have they lost? One of them has lost her productive years, her budding career, her promotions, travel opportunities, and maybe a little bit of love and romance and all the humdrum of life. Oh, and women, some women gain a few kilos also. And what has the other girl lost? That she wants motherhood so desperately. You know, it's an important being of being a woman. And I think it's really important that we get hold of both the aspects. Because today we are women who want to do something. We have a fire in our belly. So what is the solution? Technology is offering a solution. That is egg freezing. I think it's a fantastic technology. And today it is a reality. Imagine, I love an ice cream, so I would put it away in the fridge. In the freezer, and 2 months later, when I want to, you know, I feel like eating that particular flavor, I open my fridge and take out that ice cream to satisfy my midnight hunger pangs. Similarly, you can stash away your eggs in cold storage and have a baby whenever you want. That much freedom has been given to women by egg freezing. It's very radical. I know. It's very, very radical. But what is this technology? This technology is vitrification. You can see the video on the screen. And you know what we do over here? The egg is at the body temperature of 37 degrees centigrade. We take it on this little straw and we dip it into liquid nitrogen, which takes it to minus 196 degrees centigrade rapidly. How rapid is the drop in temperature? Minus 20,000 degrees per minute. And that change in technology has, you know, resulted in those eggs surviving. It's so rapid, there are no ice crystals. And today, with this technology, the survival of the eggs is 97 to 99%. And that is why this technology can be used. So if you look at those patients with low ovarian reserve because of endometriosis, because of cancer, you know, the chemotherapeutic drugs, the radiotherapy is toxic to the ovary. So all these girls, before undergoing therapy, can freeze their eggs. The next question you'll ask, like, you know, is it very expensive? But let's take any middle-income family. Don't you invest 1 lakh rupees in a car today? The car is a necessity of your life. Right? So then, why not invest in this project? It's your fertility insurance. It's the insurance for having safe future generations. I think it may sound very ambitious and very far-fetched to all of y'all. But awareness is what is important. And if we spread this awareness, it will become more popular and more people will go for it. And when there are more people giving the service, I think the technology will become affordable. Do you remember how expensive the smartphones were when they came? Today, they're available for pittance. I think the same is the thing about any technology. The more it becomes popular, it becomes more affordable. Reproduction is the virtue of persistence of life. And we must use our capabilities, like egg freezing, to aid this virtue. You know, yesterday I was at the airport and this young woman came running to me and hugged me. I looked at her. She said, "Doc, thank you so much." She said, "I'm your patient who froze my eggs 5 years ago with you. And today, I am boarding a flight to Chandigarh to marry the man of my choice. But in the meantime of 5 years, what I did was, I went abroad, started a startup, and sold it for millions." She's saying, "Because I had my eggs with you frozen, I was not worried about finding the Mr. Right. And now I'm going to Chandigarh, I'm getting married. And if I have problems, I know I can come back to you and have a baby. You gave me freedom." I think all the women, I'm actually getting goosebumps, you know, all the women should have this freedom, this independence, to think about what they want in life. Because we are all multitasking. Times are changing now. And definitely, we need to change with it. Look at Diana Hayden today. She's happy. She's evolved. And what has she become? You know something? She may be probably the world's first woman to freeze eggs for social reasons as far back as in 2007. That time, this was experimental and it was being used for cancer patients. So she has become not only, you know, she's become a motivational speaker and she's talking about it. And she really tells me that, you know, every time we used to tell her, "Please get married, you're getting too old." She said, "What I did was right. I found the person of my dreams at the age of 40. So friends, what I would just like to say is, it's not just because nature demands, but for humanity and for love, I think this idea is worth spreading.